Hello, my name is Tim Wander, author and historian, and we're now standing outside the Marconi Wireless Telegraph Company's main factory, the New Street Works. Built in 1912, it was the world's first purpose-built wireless and electronics factory, and took over directly from the world's first wireless factory at Hall Street, both of them, of course, in Chelmsford. Now, as we move ahead, we're rapidly approaching the 100th anniversary of radio broadcasting in Britain. And it all started here. The very first experiments in 1920 came from these works. Now, one fateful night in June 1920, Dame Nellie Melba, famous soprano, came here, walked through these doors to give the first ever paid concert by a professional artiste. Sponsored by the Daily Mail, Melba came, and she wasn't a great fan. She didn't want her voice tampered with by the young wireless wizards and the magic play boxers. But she saw a commercial opportunity because record sales had already been dropping. So in June 1920, from huge 450-foot high aerials that towered above the New Street Works and the Chelmsford town, her voice was heard across the world. Signal reports from Iran and Iraq and the south of France. Even ships sailing around the south coast of America reported they had heard Madame Melba. And in the streets of Paris, they sang and danced to her music, broadcast live for the first time. There are places and moments in time that are very special. This is one of those places, and that was one of those moments. This is where the modern age of wireless and radio broadcasting began. This is the home of broadcasting. Those early experiments started a chain of events the young engineers could never have foreseen. Ditcham and Round, with their joking reading of Bradshaw's train timetable and newspapers, started a chain of events that led to concert from Melba, Clara Butt, Lawrence Melchior, and within 2 years, Peter Eckersley, standing in a hut in Whittle, calling CQ. And he became the birth of the British Broadcasting Company. But it all started here.